What's happening, my beautiful people? My name is Mike LaBelle. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. If you or you or you have not slapped something on the LaBelle, you haven't turned on notifications, I'm slightly disappointed. And this past weekend, Lee, did you experience connectivity issues? Did you feel that the mechanics were being abused to the highest degree? If the answer is yes, please like this video because I felt the gameplay was different. A little more sluggish, and then the consistency of connectivity problems that I was running into, and just the types of players, the abuse of tactics. I'd never seen so many bus drivers, and it almost felt as if there was this re-addition or revamped overload ball side, and players were just crowding the middle of the virtual pitch, and there were so many bodies around you, but they weren't adamant or aggressive or moving with any self-urgency. It was a frustrating weekend. So like the video if you felt the same way. Comment below, where was your weekend league record? Am I going crazy? Did you notice something similar? There was a lot of emotion on the live stream. If you missed the live stream, I suggest that you get over there, run up a past broadcast, twitch.tv/MikeLaBelle. I didn't have the best time this past weekend. In fact, I couldn't get it together. I couldn't find the free flow, the fluidity, the motion, the movement. And I made the age-old error of not taking a break once you're starting down that slippery slope of gameplay destruction. I wasn't clocked in mentally. I wasn't clocked in on the sticks. I just wasn't dialed. And it was painful. Let's talk about the squad. There's going to be a lot of intense matchups. And if you struggled this past weekend, I feel as if you're going to relate. Enjoy. What's up, my beautiful people? You know we equal, man. It's dirty. Hurry, gather round. Don't you worry, hold it down. This one's going through the town. Pass it around, one, two, other wall of life. Like it's FIFA, and I only came to bow. Squad on screen. Of course, what we started, not that important, but we played a 4-3-2-1 and then went into primarily a 4-2-2, played a little 4-2-3-1 as well, but I struggled with formations. And I'm going to go back to the drawing board. I'd like to rework, maybe add a new formation into my lineup just in order to try to counteract some of the tactical abuse that I witnessed throughout the weekend league. Also, I know you're going to say, Mike, Gareth Bale, is it time for him to go? Is this his last weekend? Why didn't you use Lucas? I do believe we're going to make a shift. It depends on the collective of the team. So in this squad, I didn't need the likes of a Gareth Bale because we already had Talisca, we already had Rashford, big bodies. A lot of times I like Gareth Bale just as an outlet because he has an unusual and a unique body type and structure. He's pretty safe for lobbing the ball out of the back, for trying to beat a team press. But I do feel as if the game's caught up to him to a certain degree, but he's also affordable. Neymar was our major signing. There's no doubt about that. And I'll give you the stats for our two main killers up top. It looks ridiculous for Rashford overall. 159, 233, and 107. You want to look at contribution. He's giving you a 2-1 every single match. It's unbelievable. But this past weekend, he had 46 goals and 23 assists. And Neymar, right next to Rashford, whether playing as a secondary striker or center attacking midfielder, had 36 goals and 28 assists. So offensively, both these guys were very relevant. But I did feel as if I relied on them too much. I didn't have enough team building. And you might question, why is that important? If everything becomes one twos between your two attackers, you're starting to leave out variety within your build-up play, variety within how you counterattack, the fast movements, and you become more predictable as well. You need to include your midfield, whether it's the center mids or the left mid, the right mid. You have to keep your opposition guessing, even more so when you're going up against more upper echelon oppositions. I also believe strongly that Militao, even though he's good and he's overpowered, I felt the difference of not having the likes of a Virgil van Dijk or an informed Kyle Walker or a Varane, because every weekend league team I went up to, Varane. And it matters. Big body takes up space, makes saves, makes blocks. You have to beat him multiple times. The more and more I've played FIFA 21 as EA has introduced new updates or new patches, it's starting to resemble FIFA 20. I don't like saying that on camera, but we do have next gen that starts at the very beginning of December. Did you guys get a console? No spoilers, but you see this PS5 on deck. The vibes are heavy. It has arrived. I have not unpacked it, obviously. It will be ready to go for next weekend, but I don't think it changes anything regarding the gameplay until everyone's playing on those servers, that weekend league, which from my understanding all kicks in at some point in December. Quickly, let's talk squad. Defensively, everything was as you would expect it to be other than Militao's best time period of FIFA, at least this year. It's behind him. Offensively, Paulinho and Alan in the midfield, both decent, but I was frustrated, therefore I was rushing so much. I could have asked for more from a positioning standpoint, but I also didn't play drop back. I didn't play park the bus. I didn't run back a bunch of players manually. I just didn't play into some of the meta methods from what I saw throughout this past weekend. Offensively, Talisca was still a beast. I would have preferred to maybe have him up front with Rashford, but then I didn't want to lose the value of Neymar, who has some of the best, if not the best, footwork in FIFA 21. Gareth Bale did not have a heavy contribution weekend, and I told you, I was way too reliant just between having Rashford and having Neymar. When you have two of the most gifted attacking players in this year's installment, it's so easy to rinse, wash, repeat, and to just completely create attacks via these two superstars that can win a lot of the matchups, that can take players on, that both have the five-star skills. And I left so much of my offensive creativity and innovation and how I like to orchestrate attacks off the virtual pitch. And as I got more frustrated, if you saw some of the games, I was rushing and I did not close out matches that were very simple closeout games. I even brought in Akinfenwa multiple times before the game was over. I was trying to shake and bake and mix and match and have fun playing throughout the weekend, and I got ahead of myself. But enjoy the gameplay. I hope you guys had a better weekend than yours truly. Let me know. Records down below. I appreciate all of you. Just got Timo Werner, red. On point to play this style of opponent. Yep. There it is. That is end line work at its finest. You're welcome. Watch and learn. Park your bus. Perfect. We like that. Make mistakes. Make errors. Just straight counterattack, man. Why? Why? When did the game become this, bro? Just straight counterattack. Everybody I play against. Disgraceful style. Disgraceful. Pen? I can't get anything going. It turns into a goal. I just want to break, like, what do you want me to do? He made a bad decision. All he did was make bad decisions. It just bounces back. That's just such a good goal. The people I play against don't even have that ability. He keeps it with Sissoko! My goodness. You can't make this stuff up, bro. I know I'm not playing well, but this is a joke. He's just standing there looking at me. Keep looking at me. Every little touch matters so much. I mean, there's things I could be doing better. Don't get me wrong. What? Bro. Like, it's just bad decision making. The first pass is bad. The second pass is bad. Move the keeper. Move the damn keeper. Move him. You're welcome. That is what you call composure. Leave the game. You don't deserve to be here. Wrong skill to go with there. That's too bad. Oof. chip. One chance. Beautiful. All that work, and that's the mistake he makes. All that work.